Hello everybody, today to drink wine we use a glass made of glass and a bottle made of glass also, but in this video I want to show you how the ancient Greeks used to drink wine, and I will show you also other interesting things about ancient times. You will discover it if you follow me in this very beautiful archaeological museum of Syracuse. Okay, so we start this video about Greek vases from the most important Greek vase in a home. It was the crater. It was the largest vase. Sometimes it had a capacity of 20 liters. So it was very big, with a big mouth, beautiful decorations, and also very big foot, very large foot, because they should stand in the table. They shouldn't be curvy, okay? They were not made for transportation, but just to stay in the table. Because at that age the wine was not very good, so they used to make a blend. They used to mix wine with water, spices, honey, so the taste was better. And the scholars, they divide craters in four main types. There is the one with the a colonnette, we say in Italian, with little columns, because the shape of the handle is made with little columns. And then there is also the crater bell-shaped, because if you see, it's like the shape of a bell, and the handles are in the higher part of the vase. But after, you have to know, there is the other one, it's called crater with a chalix shape. Because if you see, it looks a little bit like the bell-shaped, but here in the chalix-shaped crater, the handles are at the bottom of the vase. And then the last kind of crater is the crater with volutes or scrolls on the top of the handle. So this is a crater with a volute, we say, so with volutes, scrolls on the top of the handle. The other one, unfortunately, it didn't arrive to us. So after the wine was mixed in the crater, after they should take the wine, no? And now to do this they use the chiatos. So with the chiatos they took the wine and they pour it in a jug called oinokoe. It was supposed to be incorporated into the crater, this chiatos. This is why it had a peduncle on the handle that was to tie it through a little cord or a little chain to the edge of the crater, so it didn't get lost. But chiatos could have different shapes, so they think these were also to chiatos. The classical jug for wine was called in Greek oinokoe, and it means wine pourer. Usually oinokoe they have a very long spout, so very prominent, to avoid loss of wine or drop of wine. And usually they had also a very large base, because they should be on the table, they should be shockproof. and they also had a very tall and large handle to allow to pour better the wine in the glass. Of course, there are different shapes of oinokoe. Some wine is more belly pot shape, but the function was always the same for wine. For example, this is another oinokoe with a very large body and a flat also foot. Now we can see another vase that was used to pour water in the glass. So it's different from the oinokoe because it doesn't have a pointed spout. You see, it's a regular mouth and a pot belly shape. So this is why they think it was for water. But like the oinokoe, the olpe has a unique handle, very tall and large, because it was made to pour water in the glass. Now I show you the glasses, because from the oinokoe the wine was poured in the glasses, and usually they use two kinds of glasses according to which part of the crater the wine was taken, because if the wine was taken in the higher part of the crater was very good, but if the wine was taken at the bottom of the crater it wasn't so good. It was full of impurities, full of lees, because it was mixed with a lot of other stuff. So they need two kind of different glasses. So the most important glass was called Kylix, that it like a Chalix of today for champagne. A little bit is very flat because it was made of good wine. There are different sizes of Kylix. This is a Kylix. These are two Kylix. Look how it's beautiful. This other one with two eyes in the external part. So when someone was drinking, it's like the eyes protect the person also while he was drinking. Fantastic, no? So let's go to see if the wine was not good. So the wine that was taken at the bottom of the crater, they used two kind of glasses, the Skiphos and the Cantharos. So these are two Cantharos, that in Greek it means springing up Cantharos, because if you see the handles are very tall and they look like springing up. And they also had the Cantharos a very tall foot. This is the Skiphos. The Skiphos had the same function of the Cantharos. If you see also the Cantharos was very deep, because this is more simple. Because they were made, the Skiphos and the Cantharos, for the wine full of impurities, full of lees, so the glass should allow the lees to be deposited at the bottom of the glass, so they didn't drink the lees of the wine. So again, I show you Skiphos and Cantharos. They are deeper than Kylix, because they were for another kind of wine, the worst one. But here in the museum we have really different kinds of these glasses. Look how is beautiful this Skiphos. And then we have also a very big Cantharos. Look here how is big. But there is another vessel that has the same function of Skiphos and Cantharos, and it is called Riton. The Riton is not from Greek origin, because It was born at East in Mesopotamia, and after the Persian Wars, it arrived in Greece. So it has the same function of Cantharos and Skiphos, so to drink the wine that has lees, or also the beer that has lees, because in ancient times also beer had many lees, many impurities. The reason then was used to drink the best part of the wine, but when it had a hole at the bottom, actually was the opposite. You drink from there, so it just has the form of the rhythm, but it is used for another reason. Now I show you another vessel that it has a very elongated form and a very little mouth. It is called Lekythos. And it was made for milk. This is why often also the decoration of the Lekythos are white to remind the color of milk. But you have to know that these Lekythos, they were also used for funeral purpose, because today we take flower in the tombs of the dead. But in the past they also use to took milk. They also used to put inside the tomb of the dead milk, also the day of the funeral. Here there are the white one. Now I show you the amphora. It's a general name today, amphora, but actually this was the amphora, very symmetrical vase with two handles in the sides, because the name amphora in Greek, it means brought from two sides, and it was used to transport wine by land or also by sea. But if it was transported by sea, it was pointed shape, the foot. So these are the amphoras with a pointed shape to transport them by land or by sea. So the pointed shape was good to fix them in a layer of sand in the storage rooms of the boat or of the chart. This shape was good also to fix them against each other, and then they tied them with a cord all together. But you have to know that over time the amphoras evolved, and it was used also as a prize. This is why some of them are very beautiful, because it was the prize for par excellence. As a wedding present also was used, or the typical prize given to the athletes who competed at various games and at the Olympics. So the cup of today in the sport derives from there. The typical amphora made for sport was called Panathenaika, because made for the games called Panathene in Athens, dedicated to the goddess Athena, and they were filled with olive oil that was the prize for athletes. This kind of amphoras for sport had the image of the goddess Athena, and in the other side, the sport speciality for which the amphora was offered as a prize. But an important thing to say about wine, it's also that if you went in a shop, in a Greek shop called Taberna, you could find wine. And they used to store and sell wine in animal sacks made with animal skins. Now I show you the vase that was used to transport water instead of wine. It was called Idria. As you can see, it has three handles, two in the sides like the normal amphora, but another one vertical on the top, because it was made to take also the water in the public fountain. So when you carried the vase that was empty, you brought it by the vertical handle. But when it was full of water, you carried it with the two handles in the sides by hands, because it was very heavy, also 5 liters. And the Idria, like the amphora for wine, had a very little base, because they were not made to stay in the table, but for transportation. But of course, in a museum, in this one of Syracuse, we have really thousands of other vases, because each liquid, each food had his own vessel. For example, the alabastron, this one, was used for perfumes, and the other one, the ariballos, it was used for oil in the spa, in the massage room. Of course, smaller it is the vase, and more precious should be the substance, the liquid inside, okay? Like today, more or less. But for example, a lot of times we have really little vessels like skifos, calyx, oenochoe, everything made in a little model. This is why they were used also for funeral purpose, so inside the tomb. Some of them were made just for decoration, to stay in the home, to be proudly showed. But for example, like this one was a crater that was used also as a urn for the bones of the dead people in the tomb. Okay, so this video finishes here. I hope you enjoyed it. Of course, in this museum we can understand many other things about ancient times, and we can discover very, very beautiful pieces of art. If you are looking for a guide in Syracuse, for the museum, for the town, all the southeast of Sicily, I am available. So, arrivederci! Salute!